Great, we're going to keep this nice and intimate. Hello, Seymour.
Hi, how are you?
Welcome to the Tim Peaks Diner.
I have no idea what you want to talk to me about.
Well, it's mainly about you, Seymour. Oh. No, that's the whole idea. We want to talk about you. So, I understand that you're a big patron of the Liverpool Sound City. You've come practically every single year, I think.
I think I've been here just about every year. I think I missed one, maybe even two, but not more than that. Dave Piccolinghi, who is the person I work with, the organizer, I've known him from back in his days, when he worked a bit within the city and in Manchester. And I tell you, it's remarkable how this has grown. Tony Wilson, who's a great friend of mine, would be so proud and happy, even though, you know, Mancunians and Liverpudlians don't always get along, you know, but to see that up here in this area, which I think is really the heartland for British music, and they've got such a really strong festival, not just the music, which is great, but the discussions that have been going on and all that, and I'm very proud to be a part of this.
It's interesting. I heard some news this morning. That you're not just here to talk to me or hang out, but you've actually signed a band this morning.
I signed a band this morning, and I signed a band yesterday, you know, and I'm batting two for two. In fact, the acting manager of the band I signed yesterday is sitting right there in the audience. He's someone I know very well because he was in a band that I signed many years ago. The band I signed, Sugarman, yesterday, and really have great, great, great expectations for them. They're a spectacular, you know, rock and roll band, and they have what I always consider the most important ingredient: great songs. This morning, I signed another band, The Lottery Winners, who I've been watching for about a year now, and they have very good management as well, which is so important. A guy, Mark Connor, and they're really not what you would normally expect, but what I always, you know, get very excited about, when I see, I don't know. You all look so young in the audience, but many years ago, I worked towards the tail end of their career with an LA-based band called The Turtles. I don't know, Happy Together was their big hit, and they had I Only Want to Be With You, and all the things like that. And they, the Lottery Winners remind me, you know, quite a bit of them in just the overall style. And then I, about 20 years ago, I signed, another band, and they're a Canadian band called Bare Naked Ladies, and they're a bit like them as well, you know, and I like those, you know, things that are off to the side of things, you know, not mainstream. And I'm very, very happy to be associated with both these bands.
I love the idea that you're here. You've signed two new acts already. You've got
already,
such.
I'm done.
Yeah, yeah.
Please. What do you mean already? Please. Done.
Well, you know, there's still time today. You might discover your new favorite band later today. You never know. But the fact that you're still doing that, and you've got such a great history behind you already, but you're not sitting on your laurels at all. You're still looking forward, catching up with new bands, making sure that you're aware of what's going on. Now, you just cannot give up, can you?
Well, music doesn't give up. I mean, music is like a river. It just keeps flowing. And, when I was a kid growing up, there was rhythm and blues, which is wonderful and still around and still at the root of so much of great music that's coming out today, country and western music, which is, you know, it just gets wider and wider as more people around the world, you know, get involved. I mean, there was a time when so much of the music was just coming from the United States, and in fact, more music was coming from places like France and Italy and Germany than from England, pre-Beatles, you know. You had people like Lonnie Donegan, who was a real pioneer skiffle and Nancy Whiskey and that whole thing, that Charles McDevitt skiffle group. I hope I'm not boring you guys, but you had some great pop singers, really pop. I mean, don't throw tomatoes at me, because I just don't like rock and roll. I like all kinds of music. There's Vera Lynn, who helped get England through World War II with some of her beautiful, courageous songs too. But far and away, England was not a big contributor to the rest of the world. And now it is, and that's great. But I look at every country of having a ability to have hit records around the world. I've picked up bands from Australia, from Israel, South Africa, all the Scandinavian countries, and just about everywhere. What I'm really looking forward to now, anticipating it, is the great return of Latin music, with Cuba reopening up its doors, because Cuba had contributed so much to Latin music back in the 40s and 50s.
That's interesting. It would be interesting to see what happens and what impact that has. I thought one good place to start would be with Echo and the Bunnymen, because obviously we're in Liverpool. We've talked a bit about Liverpool Sound City, but you had a crucial role to play in Echo and the Bunnymen's success, in that you signed them for America.
Yes.
And my impression...
I signed them for the world, actually, not just for America.
Sorry.
No, I was walking down the street at night, and I saw a sign in front of this YMCA around Tottenham Court Road, and it said that two new Liverpudlian bands, two new Mancunian bands playing tonight. So they were unsigned, and I came down, and the opening band was Echo and the Bunnymen. I was so blown away by the songs, by the voice, by the musicianship, that I immediately, set out to sign them. And their managers were there, and we worked out a deal, and I think they were in the studio within 10 days from that first gig. And, there were other good bands there that night. A Teardrop Explodes was there the same night, not bad at all, it's true. And the guy from A Teardrop Explodes was very, kind of miffed. He wrote a book, why didn't Seymour Stein sign me too?
Why didn't you then? He didn't have the songs, or?
No. I did like them. And they were very successful. There's just so much you can do. You can just do so much, look, Liverpudlians, I love you, but you're a little crazier than most people here, and that's why you're so good.
Fantastic. I think that's all we've got time for now, but I think we should all give Seymour Stein a fantastic round of applause. Thank you very much for all the music that you've helped bring the world, Seymour. It really is very much appreciated.
Thank you.
The In Conversation stage continues. So if you want to come back, it'd be great to see you. Seymour Stein, one more time.